Let's see action. Let's see people. Let's see freedom. Let's see who cares.
Brandon Thompson is NASCAR's brand new Vice President of Diversity and Inclusion. First, congrats on the new position. Second, what a time to take over in this role. It's been quite a couple of weeks. Take us through what it's been like.
It's certainly been a range of emotions, but we certainly at first appreciate the well wishes and the congrats. It's certainly an exciting role for me, and to your point, an exciting time to get involved on this side. And so it's something that's been near and dear to my heart, candidly, for quite a while. I was a participant in the diversity internship program in 2003, and so to be able to have it come full circle has been pretty cool.
As you mentioned, you've been involved in NASCAR for a long time. NASCAR is arguably a very white sport, which isn't a bad thing. When you work on diversity, is it an effort to bring in more people of color primarily, or just create a better understanding within the NASCAR community of various issues that many of the people might not be familiar with?
Yeah, I don't think it's tough to hone in on just one thing there, right? I think it's number one, it's diversity and inclusion in the way that our world is going. We know that the stats say that, you know, some 15, 20 years down the line, the demographics of this country are going to shift. And so I think any organization, whether inside sports or not, that doesn't adapt to that change is going to be in trouble. And so aside from that, it's the right thing to do. We don't want anyone to feel like that they're not welcome, whether to be employed by NASCAR or to enjoy our races. I think certainly hope to you and the fans would agree that racing is something that's exciting, it's invigorating, certainly something that's captivating and holds your attention and extremely entertaining. And so anytime you're dealing with anything that fun and that lively and that electric, you want everyone to be able to participate in that. And that's certainly the approach that we're taking.
You've had your drive for diversity, still do, NASCAR. Had black drivers, very few. Bubba Wallace is the current one. Bill Lester in the past. Brad Doherty is an owner of color. What's kept the sport from expanding to more people of color, more backgrounds?
I think the first thing that comes to my mind, Rob, is exposure. I can use myself as an example. I grew up in Nashville, Tennessee, not too far from the Nashville Fairgrounds Speedway, and never made it out, right? My grandmother lived less than 2 miles from the place. Obviously, with my dad and my uncles, you know, they all coached me in football, played football. You know, the first time I played was for my uncle and my dad as co-coaches there. And point is, they never mentioned anything about NASCAR until I did my internship at the Nashville Super Speedway. And so that's the thing when you ask, you know, what's kind of kept people away from it. The first thing that comes to mind for me is exposure. So I think that's one of the things that we're going to take a good hard look at. One of the things, candidly, that you've seen that we've done through the internship program, through the Drive for Diversity program, not only from the driver standpoint, but also from the crew member aspect as well. And so we'll look to continue and expand those efforts in the future.
Bubba Wallace has been at the center of news over the last couple of weeks. He's very outspoken. Had the unfortunate, terribly unfortunate incident in the garage area at Talladega. How important is Bubba to the sport right now?
Very important, and it's been that way. And as important as he is, Rob, there's no question how important he is and what he's meant to the momentum that we're carrying here over the last couple of weeks. But I think just as important are the drivers who are non-black, right? And so whether that's Daniel Suarez, who's Mexican, or just the rest of the garage. So when you look at a Jimmy Johnson or a Tyler Reddick or a Ty Dillon, all the people who have come out, and Denny Hamlin, and the list goes on. I could list the entire roster based on what we saw in Sunday's events, but just as important is the support that Bubba's getting from his peers, right? And so I think it's important to highlight that as well.
It's important. It's very important to highlight that. And it brings me to my next question. Why do you think the support among Bubba's peers is so strong, yet there's still a divide in our society, whether it's the fan base of NASCAR in sometimes different prejudices, whether it's people here in Minnesota? Why don't we learn more from sports, in other words, and do a better job of simply getting along, understanding each other better?
Well, listen, I think, unfortunately, there are always people in society who fall on the periphery, right? And so I think that what you're seeing is just that sports is no different than broad. It's just, it's only a subset of broader society. And so I do, and whether that's the fans or anything like that. So I certainly feel like this industry is in the process of turning a corner. We're going to get that. We're going to turn that corner, continue with this momentum that we have. And again, one of the things that I come back to is that the overwhelming majority of fans, the overwhelming majority of the people attending the sports, the overwhelming majority of those participating, the industry is behind this this movement and this change. And listen, it's good for everybody, good for the industry as a whole. And so it's important that we keep that in mind.
As we wrap up, I'm going to ask you the same question I've been asking everybody, especially in wake of the tragic events in Minnesota, the challenges that Bubba Wallace has faced. What gives you hope as you look to the future?
I look no further than what happened again at Talladega on Sunday on pit road during the pre-race ceremonies. When you look at the fact that an entire industry of people who I've worked on the competition side of this sport, Rob, basically for my entire career up to this point, and I can tell you from managing rules and races and all those sorts of things that it is very, very rare to get an entire industry of racers to agree on anything. And when you look and saw what that display of the entire garage area, crew members, crew chiefs, drivers, owners, coming together in support of Bubba Wallace yesterday after those terrible events, that's what gives me hope. It gives me hope that the support that I've seen since my position was announced a week ago, overwhelming majority of that has been positive. When Ken Squire writes me a letter in support of what we're doing, that's what gives me hope. And so, and those are just a few things from my personal experience, right? But when you look at society as a whole, the events that are taking place in Minneapolis, some of the laws and things like that are already beginning to change. Those are the things that give me hope. We'll get this done. I don't have any question in my mind.
Brandon Thompson, you are the Vice President for Diversity and Inclusion with NASCAR. Thanks so much for sharing your insights.
Thank you, Rob, for having me. Thanks for the opportunity.